Hello there folks, my name is Spooks and I saw The Bad Guys and it was great. Now I was actually really looking forward to this movie. The trailers looked great, it seemed to be really funny, I liked the premise a lot, even though it did seem a little bit similar to Megamind, but Megamind was also a little bit similar to Shrek, so whatever. And the animation looked very impressive and very stylized. I loved the look of the film overall, and it just in general looked like one of DreamWorks' best movies in recent years, as while I did like a number of their movies they put out over the years, I definitely felt they could have been better, and maybe if they worked on them a little bit more, they could have even become one of their best movies in recent years, but I was still satisfied with them. But regardless, yeah, I was really looking forward to this, and I can safely say that my expectations were not only met, they were also kind of exceeded. I had a blast with The Bad Guys. First off, the animation is beautiful. Like I discussed earlier, I was really liking what DreamWorks was offering in terms of animation, judging from the trailers. It looked very unique, very stylized, and seemed to be taking some inspiration from other stylized animated movies like the Peanuts movie, the Mitchells vs. the Machines, Captain Underpants, and of course, Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse. And DreamWorks has seemingly nailed this as of late, especially with this movie, as it looks really smooth, really well polished. The designs are all very appealing. It's fast, it's energetic, and it's just that perfect blend of 2D and 3D that I just love seeing from these types of movies. And I look forward to seeing what DreamWorks does with these stylized animated movies in the future with their upcoming new Puss in Boots movie, which also seems to be taking inspiration from movies like this, which in my opinion, the animation on that film also looks really good. As for the story itself, I also thought that was really well done here. Like I said, it is something we've seen time and time again before, but that doesn't really matter if the execution is really stand out. And this movie's execution of the story is really stand out. Like I said, it does feel like very similar to Megamind and Shrek. Basically, that plot of basically some character or creature once sought out as the enemy wanting to change themselves for the better, and I feel this movie definitely took advantage of that plot as it went in some very interesting directions and it didn't seem very preachy. It handled its subject matter very well, and all around it was also a very well done heist film. I know many people who worked on this film said, yeah, it's a parody of heist films like Reservoir Dogs and Ocean's 11, in the same way that Kung Fu Panda was for Kung Fu movies and Shrek was for fairy tales. But in all honesty, this is a pretty great standalone heist film on its own. It really makes it stand out amongst the crowd, and it's just a very fun and entertaining movie to see where they use these common tropes you see in these types of movies and make it work in the medium of animation. And it looks and makes all of these scenarios and these plans and these heists very fun and exciting to watch. Then there are the characters. First, there are the bad guys themselves. They are a ton of fun to watch. You can tell they just love committing crimes and being reviled by society, and they also love and respect each other. They love doing this. They each care about one another. They're all so likable and entertaining to watch. And while some of them aren't as developed or as interesting as some of the others, which we'll get to later, they still make up for that with so much personality and energy, and the voice acting from all of the actors who were cast to play them. Really solid job, DreamWorks, with the casting. And they were just really likable, so much so that I wouldn't even mind seeing these characters again in another movie. There are also the secondary characters, who I won't get into too much because that dives into spoiler territory, but they're also really entertaining to watch, and they also lead into some, like I said, very unique twists and turns you may or may not see coming. But still, given the performances, their personalities, and the way they were written, they still make it a ton of fun to watch these characters be on screen. And the last positive thing I will say about this movie is that it is hilarious. I laughed out loud several times throughout it. This is honestly the funniest DreamWorks movie I have seen since Captain Underpants. I really cracked up a lot throughout the movie, whether it be the slapstick, the expressions the characters would make, how zippy the animation is, or, just a one-liner. It was all really funny and cracked me up throughout a large majority of the movie. However, there are unfortunately a couple of problems I do have with this movie. First off, not every joke lands. There are a couple of bad puns, bad childish humor, and there's a really bad running gag that is just basically one elaborate fart joke that just was not funny, and I kind of cringed every time they would bring it back up. I also wish some of the other characters, specifically Mr. Shark, Miss Tarantula, and Mr. Piranha, were explored a bit more. I still liked them, and they were all funny and had their moments in the movie, but compared to Mr. Snake and Mr. Wolf, who were very well developed and had more interesting going on with the plot, I kind of wish they gave the rest of the crew some more interesting things to do in the movie. And then lastly, there is the climax. There was a point where I was starting to get a little tired of everything it was throwing at you, from the big action set piece to the twists and turns they threw at you, that a couple of which I already saw coming. And just overall, it was becoming a little bit too bloated for me in terms of everything that was going on with the film. I kind of wish they cut it a little bit short or made it a little bit more interesting with everything that was going on throughout it, and I think the climax would have been a lot better in my opinion. I still liked the ending and the resolution for the characters. I thought that was actually really mature and really smart way to end the film, but just the how we got there was a bit overwhelming in my opinion. But overall, everyone, I really liked The Bad Guys. I think this is definitely a nice step in the right direction for DreamWorks, and if this is where they're heading for this decade or in the future of where they're going with the studio, I'm all here for it. The animation is stylized and wonderful and pleasing to look at. The story was really good. It's a great, fun heist parody and just a good heist movie in general. The characters are all really likable and it's hilarious. I definitely recommend all of you go check it out. It's a really strong family film, and I think the kids and the adults will definitely get something out of it. I think everyone will have a good time watching this movie. It was really fun. Definitely go check this out, as I highly recommend it. And those were my thoughts on The Bad Guys. What did you all think of it if you've seen it? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Comment down below and let me know. If you like this video, hit the like button. If you like this channel, hit the subscribe button. Follow me on all the social media links at the end of the video. And until next time, everyone, stay sharp.
Bad to the bone. Bad to the bone. Bad. Bad. Bad.